on to the bigger issue that I do want to address is Jamboree in the Hills. I know a lot of people obviously are upset with all the new changes. I got as many phone calls as much as the other, you know, people that are entertainers here in the High Valley, from the bands, from the DJs that work at the station. Here's my thought on everything, and when I think you see the end of this video, I think you're really going to appreciate this more or less. I was up in the morning just like everybody else was. I was up at 7:30. I didn't see the interview on WTOV 9, but I tuned in to 98.7. I'm more of a radio guy than watching TV. And, you know, I listened to, you know, them make the announcement. And, of course, I saw the video just like everybody else from WTOV9. I got two text messages right off the bat within the next 3 hours. You know, hey, I need this person's cell phone number. You're crazy if you think I'm going to release somebody's cell phone number that is associated with Live Nation or Clear Channel Radio. You're absolutely insane. I mean, like, there's a trust issue there. I'm never going to break that. And it's also not my place. If that was me in that situation, I would not want my information from my close friends or my close acquaintances to say, oh, hey, don't tell them how I got it, but here's the information. One of the things I think why everybody keeps on asking me some questions about this stuff is because either they either think I worked for the station at one point or I just have all these connections. And it's like, regardless if I worked there at one time or if I did not, I'm still not going to say anything. It's not my place. Do I agree with some of the changes? No, I don't. You know, I understand that everybody's upset about this. I understand that some people are wanting to boycott things. That's fine. You know, I support that. Go do what you want to do. You have freedom of speech. I'm personally not going to do it because I'm not going to put myself in that situation. But I support and I understand and I get why everybody's kind of up in arms about it. And I'd be lying if I said I was not intrigued and not looking at some of the gossip that was going on between Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, because I knew Monday was going to be the announcement. And I can't say one of my biggest pet peeves, and we've had this conversation. One of the biggest pet peeves I hate busybodies. And I'm never gonna name drop people's names, but I hate busybodies who just automatically just want to start some type of drama, and I can't stand it, and then it just gets everybody else involved, and then you have this few people that don't know anything about the topic that throw their two cents in, and they think, well, I heard it's going to be this way, and all this other stuff, and it just kind of gets annoying. I support anybody's decision to protest. That's fine. You know, just please be respectful. You know, the people that work for Live Nation that live here locally, it's not ultimately their call, and you have to understand that. If you just take 2 seconds to step back and realize that, you know what, that person works for somebody else. She can throw her opinions around. He can throw his opinions around. It doesn't mean that they actually take it. They're going to take it into consideration, but ultimately, it's somebody that doesn't live around here that makes that call. So is that person that ultimately makes that call, is that person going to come and make that announcement to everybody here in the High Valley? No. Somebody's going to have to take the fall. And that's pretty much exactly what happened. I understand if you're upset with people, that's fine. You're upset with the company, you're upset with the name change, I get it. Trust me, I get it. There's a difference between voicing your opinion and just being plain out disrespectful and rude and ignorant. You know, these people have families just like you and me. There's no need to get vulgar, there's no need to do threats, there's no need to do name calling. It's just uncalled for. If you think that these people that work locally did not fight for some of these changes not to happen, you're crazy. From my point of view, Jamboree in the Hills is a very unique place. My first time being there was 2001. I went with one of my best friends at the time, Chad Malarski. We went, I think it was the year we saw Hank Williams Jr. play. The next year I went for a couple days, not just one, and saw Alabama's farewell tour. And it doesn't get much more country than Alabama right there. I mean, that was an amazing show on that Saturday night. The following year, I started camping out there. And, you know, when the announcements actually officially got announced Monday and everything kind of started sinking in, I started kind of just reflecting on, man, some of the great times that I've had at Jamboree in the Hills. And, you know, some of the new changes, yeah, they're really not what I wanted either, but you kind of have to still move forward. You know, what would I have liked to have seen? You know, this is coming from somebody, you got to understand, I've actually been there as a fan. I've worked there in the event staff, and then I've been on stage this past year. So I've kind of seen all three sides of this. And I really pay attention to detail when people voice their opinions, when I'm watching the crowds. You know, regardless if I'm in the crowd, on the stage, or working there, I always pay attention to detail with the crowd. And I loved the connections. I loved the relationships that I made out there. It was absolutely so much fun. There's so many different stories that I could tell, and I'm not going to ramble on about this. So some of the other people that I've seen comment about, if you're this upset about getting drunk, you know, if you're this upset about coolers, like you have a serious problem, you need to, you know, go get help and all this other stuff. Those people you don't understand. You've never been out there, and that's why maybe a crowd's not your thing. Maybe country music's not your thing. But it's not about going out there and getting drunk. Some of these people that work 9 to 5, you know, they plan their vacations, you know, 9 months, a year out, anticipating that this is their vacation. You know, people come on from Canada that I've met, people from Jersey, people from Wisconsin, people from Carolinas that come up to this. You know, they work those 9 to 5s. They come up here and they plan their vacations out already. So it's not about, you know, going over there and just getting drunk and getting hammered and things like that and just being reckless and getting out of control. You know, the uniqueness of being able to come in with your coolers, design your own coolers, dress each other up, have some fun. The costumes, gentlemen, the costumes that you saw over there. I mean, unbelievable, some of the fun stuff. Of course, you know, the group that always worked with Neil McCoy when he took the stage and interacted with him. You know, a lot of that stuff obviously is going to be different now. What I wish they would have done, would have been nice, was, you know, if you're going to implement the alcohol, okay, implement the alcohol, but still allow them to come in with the coolers. You know, test it out for the first year. Ultimately, you guys have the power to voice your opinion. I mean, I've noticed that from Friday on to today. I mean, Friday night, when I looked at Jamboree's Facebook page, they were at 4.6 star rating, and now it's at a 2.3. So, I mean, you have your voice. It's one of the three biggest events here in the Ohio Valley, and from a small business owner, I think of, you know, the businesses that will be affected by this, obviously. I'm not going to name those businesses, but we all know where they're at. They're all in Belmont County. But you have Jamboree in the Hills, you have the Festival of Lights, you have the Super Six. I mean, those are three big money-making things for the economy here in the Ohio Valley. And this, I don't want to see this event leave. So what I would like personally to see is to see everybody kind of come to a happy medium. Whether that happens or not, I have no idea. Basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to sit back and just kind of like let everything kind of unfold. You know, looking at the lineup, everybody's different. Some friends I cannot have conversations with about music. I mean, they are just completely one-dimensional. You know, some people love, you know, the new country. Some people love the 90s country. Some people love just the outlaw country and the older country and the classic country. I love it all. As a DJ, I mean, I just personally, I love it all. I mean, if you ask me what my favorite genre is, I'm going to say whatever my crowd's into. That's what I fall in love with. Personally, you know, Thomas Red, I've seen him a couple times. For those of you actually that do not know, I mean, that's Red Akins' son. And he's a hell of a songwriter. He is an up-and-coming, huge artist. He's going to be headlining a lot of stuff this year. And I'm a huge fan of Thomas Rhett. I cannot wait to see him. Jason Aldean, I mean, Entertainer of the Year, I think he's nominated for again, coming up possibly. Jason Aldean puts on an amazing show. If you've never seen his shows before, I mean, it's definitely one you don't want to miss. Lady Antebellum, I remember seeing them down at Marshall County Fairgrounds. I actually have a bandana that's signed by all three of them. And I listened to their first album and I was like, man, I remember when I was meeting them and I talked all 3 months, like, man, you three are going to make it big, and I can't wait to see all this kind of unfold and to see how big they are. You know, it's great. Now, some of the people that are complaining that are my friends that, you know, don't like that kind of country music, it's like, well, they're closing on Saturday. Well, okay, let's talk about that real quick. Do you know their tour manager? Do you know their record label? You know, if it's me booking it, me personally, and I know nobody that works locally for Live Nation is going to get upset with me saying this, because you're going to see where I'm going with this. If it was me personally, I would have Lady Antebellum on Thursday, Thomas Rhett on Friday, Jason Aldean on Saturday. Ultimately, knowing what comes out of Jamboree in the Hills, that would be the ideal setup. But guess what? Just like you watching this video, I don't know how those negotiations work. I don't know how those things get booked. If you think that they just got booked last week, you're crazy. So I'm just, like I said, I'm going to sit back and just kind of like let everything unfold. I'm excited to see everybody at some point here in 2017. And I started thinking, you know, if this is the last year of Jamboree in the Hills, then that means that, you know, it's the last year for the coolers. And I didn't take my cooler this year. I didn't take my cooler, actually. I had too much kind of going on, so, But I did think of a cool way to kind of honor it. And I think we're going to do that right now. What do you think? You up for it? You up for
your alcohol was in my cooler.
Yeah, because I couldn't actually take it. So yeah. What we're going to do is I brought the cooler in to the studio. Gentlemen,
thank you.
Pass it up to you. There you go, Cody. Mr. Man back there, you want a beer? Here you go. I'm not going to name drop who you are back there. And I don't know what they're going to do with the, countdown. But I started thinking, well, this is the last year for Jamboree in the Hills. Then that means it's going to potentially be the last year for the Jamboree in the Hills countdown. So I figured, well, I get into this stuff. No offense to the DJs on the radio station that actually do this, that actually perform this out at the campgrounds, and they know that. But I like to have a lot of fun with this. So one last time, we're going to do the Jamboree in the Hills countdown. Now here's the thing. I'm going to post some pictures of some of my favorite memories from the past 12 years that I've been going out there. So what I'd like to see is you guys actually in the threads post your favorite pictures. Maybe, just maybe, if we get enough pictures, I will actually go ahead and do another video, and instead of using the original, I'll use Joe Zealous to give him a shout out. But out of respect, gentlemen, if you're watching at home, we recorded this on Tuesday night. I didn't want to go live with this because there was too much going on, but the release date's Wednesday for this video, so if you're sitting at home on Wednesday night, let's crack open a little beer. And out of respect for this man, we're going to start the countdown. As always, a little Dave Nutter.
It was born in the summer of 77 in July. Just out of Wheeling, West Virginia, in the Ohio countryside. And when the sun rose on that morning, it was so peaceful, just like before. 'Cause there were thousands of people screaming, wearing smiles and clapping hands. And this was only just the beginning. What seemed like 100 country bands. It was 2 short days of fun and music, and it was turned on the radio. If you're not sure of making heaven, then it's a place you gotta go.
The Ohio Valley cheers, the Jamboree!
And I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee, a place where even squares can have a ball.
1978.
Nothing bothers me tonight. I got Don's all the scales all right. 6 days on the road and I'm gonna make it home tonight.
1979.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down.
See. 1986.
He stopped loving her today. They placed a wreath upon his door.
1987.
And that's why I hang my hat in Tennessee.
1989.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. Why my love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road.
1990.
Should have been a cowboy. And the queen of my double wine trailer with the
1997.
Jamboree!
chicken fried. Cold beer on a Friday night, a pair of jeans that fit just right, and a radio, a life seen sunrise. See the love in my woman's eyes, feel the touch of my precious child, and old mother's love.
2010!
It's when I drank my first beer. Sinners and believers, learn that happiness on earth ain't just for high achievers. I heard, I come to know there's life in holding that red dirt road.
2011.
I like my country rocking. How about you? Just put me on a stage, man. Turn it up. Yeah, give me a crown that's redneck and loud. We'll raise the roof. Hell, I might just stay all night long.
Good night.